Welcome, everyone. My mentee is Cemre. Cemre is a student at İzmir Institute of Technology, and we worked on functional analysis. And we also read, we worked on introductory functional analysis. We read a textbook about that, and then we moved on to reading a paper that tells us about decomposition of operator ideals under the continuum hypothesis. I will now leave the floor to Cemre.
Hello, everyone. Today, I will introduction to function analysis, and after that, we will look at some theorems, operator ideals under continuum hypothesis. And firstly, I will mention about norm spaces, what are norm spaces and examples of norm spaces, and after that, dual space, and we will mention Hamdanov theorem, and after that, we will move on the theorems in operator ideals. A norm space is a vector space E over a field K. It's a function E to R, and it satisfies these statements: positivity, homogeneity, and triangle inequality. If the norm has the homogeneity and the triangle inequality statements, but not necessarily the positivity statement, then it will be a semi-normal E. And as we all know, metric spaces are norm spaces, so it induces a metric space, which is dxy is equal to norm of x minus y, and this is called the canonical metric of the norm space. We will try to build a Hamdanov theorem. So we need the Banach spaces. Banach space is a norm space with the complete with respect to its canonical metric. It means that Cauchy circuits in the space converge to the point within the space. Norm spaces are continuous except the second statement, this all of that shows us it's uniform when it's uniformly continuous, and the second one shows the continuity of the norm spaces, addition, scalar multiplication, it looks like homogeneity, but not. M lambda x is equal to lambda x when it's uniformly continuous, and if the norm is go to E to R positive, it's uniformly continuous. And there are some nice examples here to understand what are norm spaces. First one is Euclidean space, and this is Rn with the norm of X sub 2 is equal to that. And sequence spaces is an example of norm space, and is that as P space with norm of X sub P, it's equal to that. And the function spaces is C A to B with norm of F sub infinity is equal to that. These are just examples of these spaces. And we can look to dual spaces now. Dual space E star is a norm space E, and it's state by this. To define the Hamdanov theorem, we need the sublinear functional P on a vector space E. It looks like the norm, and it satisfies this statement. P lambda x is equal to lambda p x, and p x plus y is less than or equal to p x plus p y. Then there is some proposition to understand Hanban theorem and it helps build the Hanban theorem. If these are hold, then like PBSM normal E, F be a subspace of E, and Y is F to K, linear function on absolute value of Y X less than or equal to P X, then there must be exist linear function y on E such that y is restricted to f is equal to y and absolute value of y x is less than or equal to p x. Then we can look to Hanban theorem. Hanban theorem is a very important theorem in function analysis. And takes by if these are hold, then it's looking like the proposition that for backslide, y restricted to f is equal to y and yx is less than or equal to px for all x element of E. And this part of the presentation, we will look the operator ideals. But we need to some preliminaries for to understand the operator ideals. Hilbert space. Hilbert space is a separable infinite dimensional complex space. And LH is the ring of bounded operators in on H. Ideal I, two-sided ideal in LH. And that includes finite rank operators. And KH is the ideal of compact operators on H. Permut is a X yields by Y if they have this same positive numbers occurs in both of them. And decrease is if Y is less than or equal to X, it means it's decrease. And X is X plus Y N is equal to X N plus Y N, it means it's N. And double is a like adding if yn is equal to 2xn, it's double. And mesh, if two sequences x and y yield by z, if the multiplicity of the occurrence z in each real number, the sum of x multiplicity in x and y, and x used by y dash shifting if gn is equal to fn plus 1 and the s set of non-decreasing functions from n to n, c0 positive, the set of all positive numbers, the set of positive and decreasing sequences, almost included means a is subset of n and such set b if a minus b is finite, it's almost included. And almost decreasing if each term is almost included in every earlier term, it means it's almost decreasing. And the function next bn, the smallest number in b that is greater than or equal to n. And this is our main theorem. Let H be a separable infinite dimensional Hilbert space and LH the ring of the bounded linear operators on H. If I is a two-sided ideal in LH, then that includes finite rank operators. Then it can be decomposed as I is equal to J1 plus J2. For some ideals, they are in subset of LH. We will write the sketch of the proof and I will mention about it, but not the original proof. If you want to look at the proof, it is in our report. Our aim is to find S1 as S2 such that element of lattice S, that is S1 and plus S2 is equal to S, where F hash star is in S, and star means is that total numbers of occurrences of 1 to 1 over 2 power of n. X star is the block to the set S that we mentioned before. Kernel of S is continuum. So assuming the continuum hypothesis, we get S can be indexed by cardinalium 1. We construct the sequences B alpha 1, alpha less than omega 1, B alpha B1 alpha, alpha less than omega 1 of infinite subsets of natural numbers using transfinite induction with these following properties. For any F alpha element of S, which alpha is less than omega 1, we have this statement, and we defined the next function before. And B alpha I is almost included in this. And we assume that these B's have been constructed for this. To construct B alpha 1 and B alpha 2, we should construct sequences. This sequence and this sequence with some special properties. We will choose sum B alpha 1 is equal to that and B alpha 2 is equal to that. And because of our contraction, the properties we will do will be satisfied. And we fix an F element of S. F is defined linearly bounded on F sub natural numbers if there exists A and B, and Fn is less than or equal to A hash n plus B for all n element of B. Sn and Si will be the closure of all F element of S, linearly bounded on one of B alpha I under that. And so S1 and S2 was element of S. If we show the S1 plus S2 is equal to S, we will prove that. So we should choose an arbitrary G element of S, and we will find F element of S. We satisfy this, and after that we will define G I n is equal to H next B alpha I n. Because of our construction, Gi was element of Ci. Then we can see that G is element of S plus S2. So it's our sketch of the proof. And these are my references. Thank you for listening.
Thank you for the presentation, Cemre. Let me stop the recording.